car leaving this morning. This was Bakersfield. We found a really nice little restaurant, little Mexican restaurant next door here. We ate the day before, and we're gonna kind of low on gas, and we're gonna go get some gas. And there's a little bit of, this is a new place, and there's a little freeway mix up right there. And we're, both of our GPS's were conflicting. So anyway, we're just taking a drive over here. This is primarily like a farming community. You'll see when we start going out of town. Cowboys and stuff like that. It's 2 hours from LA. I used to know a lot of dancers, and one in particular used to drive down to Anaheim every Sunday to Bakersfield. I tried to get some of the size of the town. It's actually a pretty good sized city. The speed limit here, I don't know, I think it's 40, 45, maybe 50 in some places. This is one of the actual main streets of town, and it turns into a highway. It's a funny story, when we came in, there was a highway patrolman sitting there just outside of Bakersfield, because you're coming off the freeways with, you know, we're running 80 miles an hour most of the time, and you come into this town, and all of a sudden you're in a 50 mile an hour speed limit, and feels like you get off and walk. And but it was pretty hot there today. It wasn't too bad, really, but it's in the summer it does get really hot, and we're heading, I believe this is one of the main routes out of town here. I thought it was going to get on a freeway, but I forgot where it was at, and this is sort of isolated from big freeways. We have to take a like a state route to continue on our way back to Los Angeles. A lot of this stuff is probably long, setting at lights and things like this. I just put a transition in to the camera. By default, it's doing a minute. So I tried not to have too many lights in here, and maybe get some of this narration in, tell you a little bit more of the town. Now, a lot of this my Russian friends will see, and of course everything's new to them. And one of the things that I noticed is that we have really good markings for our for holes in the road and construction and stuff like this, and it's fairly permanent and pretty expensive, but at least compared to Russia, they just have, you know, sometimes a plastic cone or three stuck up with a little rag on it or something, and a 3 foot hole right behind it. And our stuff is so much safer. We finally found this restaurant, so we're going in here. I don't know what this was. I think there was a Denny's, and there was a gas station right next to it, so we're gonna stop in here and get something to eat, and then we'll fill up with gas and we'll be setting out for the day. This was an interesting ride on the way through here coming to Laughlin, because we had quite a bit of freeway at high speeds, and we got off here, and I was pretty tired by the time we got here, and it was really just relaxing to drive 45, 50 miles an hour and not be screaming down the freeway at 85 or 90. I don't know why we made a turn here. I'm just sort of watching this, trying to remember what we did. I guess this wasn't where we ate, or I cut it out or something. No, I think this is where we're getting on the actually get on a freeway. He took the wrong turn there and then realized that we had missed a freeway, so luckily he cut it off and I was able to follow him. And motorcycle ran really good. I don't know if you can tell on some of these when we're coming onto the freeway. Several times I really accelerated hard there. This is one of the times here. Usually in the morning I have more energy and so I'll gas it and play around with it. Towards the end of the day I've been riding all day and I'm tired and I don't need to jerk myself around anymore. But the bike ran fine. I can hear this valve train in there rattling, and I think that's normal for the motorcycle. It might have a little bit of extra tappet noise or something. We're just going down the freeway here. This will probably cut off in a minute or so. And a lot of this road you see is tore up. They're redoing it. You'll see as we get up here towards San Francisco, there's a lot of this road that's... obviously it's been ground up and ready to be resurfaced. I don't know where this is at. I think we were out of Bakersfield now, and maybe this is, I don't know if we stop at this Denny's. I don't think so. I think we're just heading out of town. I forget exactly what we're doing at this point. Let's see if I can read this sign as it comes up. Anyway, Bakersfield's got a lot of water, and you can see the trees and stuff around there. It's a farming community. We went past a lot of places out there where guys were irrigating their fields out of a big ditch. I used to do that when I was a kid. It's actually kind of fun, but it's really hard work. And those fields are really long, especially if you're walking in them. Sometimes they're a mile long. But the main thing, this is might be a little boring, but I wanted to get some. See, here's where the road's been. They've just patched one part, probably for the utilities or something. And all of this is going to be resurfaced. This is a big road, one of the main ones into Bakersfield, and Bakersfield's one of the biggest cities around there for a couple hundred miles. And so we just keep on going here. I don't know what else to tell you about this. I'm just talking because I'm trying to put an audio track down that will be as long as a movie, so I'm going to have to watch the whole thing. I think it's about 45 minutes long. As this power director is applying some random transitions, and it's probably not a good idea when these clips are all cut exactly 1 minute, because they fit into each other, and a transition from the same thing to the same thing kind of loses its effect. We have quite a bit of construction right in here and going slow. I don't know how this looks like the video is actually lagging behind the sound a little bit, but shouldn't make any difference. And I'd put my leathers on here. It was a little chilly in the morning, but it wasn't chilly, it was hot. But when you put your chaps on, it keeps a lot of the wind and stuff off your legs, keeps from dehydrating you and stuff. Later on in the day we'll have to take that stuff off because it will get hot. And so you learn what clothes to use and when, and I need to get me some kind of a tight leather jacket. The one I've got is sort of baggy, so I can put sweaters on it under it and stuff, and the wind fills it up and whips it around and route bangs of buttons on my helmet and things like this. And I need to get a a good jacket that fits me tightly and zips up, and it keeps the wind from beating you up. We're hitting some pretty rough road in here. My buddy there, he drives kind of weird. Normally, you know, if you're in the left-hand side of the lane and you cross over to the other lane, you go all the way over to the other left, and you just go white line one side to the other. And like right now, I'm on the right-hand side. He just moves over 3 feet, and I got to go completely all the way over to the left of him on the other side. Kind of drives me crazy, but that's the way that goes. Videos kind of stopped here. Oh yeah, there was just a truck up here. I cut this out. Another light that we got stuck at. I'll be putting some music or something in this part here. So it's actually got, I'm going to try to mix this audio and the sound from the camera as well. I really should cut this whole clip out of here, just sitting behind this truck. I'm going to try to do that. Let's see if I can stop this audio. No, now it looks like we're moving, so I'll just let it go. A really beautiful sky. The little camera, I had it over to the left and it was picking too much of the windshield mount up, so now I've set it in the middle, and not only has it got a better view, but it doesn't shake as bad because it's more centered to the motorcycle instead of being out a few inches on the bar vibrating up and down. We're just heading out of town here. I don't know if this is actually playing at the same speed that my voice is. It's the same speed I'm seeing it. I see the videos kind of jumping frames, but I don't think it really has to generate anything smoothly while I'm doing the audio. Because when it goes back in, it'll take its time, and at least I hope it is. The timer's counting about right. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, so the videos should be synchronized with the audio. I haven't tried to stop the audio and edit any of the video here. Like I said, I'm just trying to narrate this. This might be a little interesting to Russians because, you know, the stuff that when you're going around there, mostly it's all forest. It's just one big forest with little holes where cities and stuff are. And, you know, I'm sure there's probably open spaces in Russia too, but I just never saw any. And so this might be interesting to the Russians to see that you can drive 200-400 miles easily in a day or so, and it's just big giant wide open spaces. A lot of this here through needles and stuff that was going down to the old Route 66, which was the only way to get to California. And this was be after you cross those mountains. Now we came from where we were at there by Oatman and Laughlin and Needles and all of that. That was the only way you got to Los Angeles, was go over those mountains. And you saw some of the, well, on the earlier videos when we had a lot of that old Route 66 in there, there's a lot of big washes and things like that, and whenever it rains, man, it just comes down and you got these flash floods, and those things are 50, 60 feet wide, so they'll be 3 feet deep, and so you learn pretty quickly to watch out for flash floods and stuff out here. So they had to go through those mountains, and then after you got through the mountains, you come down into this area here of Bakersfield, and that was your sort of gateway to the, you know, Los Angeles and also on up to San Francisco and all the farming communities and everything between there and Southern and Northern California after you come over the mountain. I don't know how I'm looking at the back of this truck, but there we go. Finally got a decent transition to a different part of the road. We're still stuck here in a 40-50 mile an hour zone. I think it's 55 maybe, or 50. I don't remember offhand, but it's not real fast. You see, we got some lights and a lot of stores and stuff. This is where we're getting right to the 5 freeway. This is the one that goes from Los Angeles straight on up north, and this is a big fast freeway. So our little 45 minute putt here at going 50 miles an hour is about over with. I was glad to see it, like I said, whenever we came down, but now I am anxious to put the pedal to the metal and get on home. This might have been one of the curves I accelerated on, because this freeway we're coming on to, the speed limit 75 and everybody's driving 80-85. So I don't know how fast I'm going here. I'm probably going 60 here. This is probably about 70. 75. I gas it because he just laid on it. So, just go ahead and crank on a little juice. Usually wait till I'm on the freeway good. I was back there at one of those places and we had this white cement there, and I gassed it getting on the freeway and it acted a little weird. It sort of felt like it was sliding around some. I looked back in the mirror and I was leaving a big long black streak. I was just burning the tire on that stuff. So the bike's got plenty of power, and it drives real good at 90 or 100. You know, you're aware you're doing 100. Part of that's because of the windscreen. It's a windshield and not a whole fairing, and so the wind blows around it, and you definitely know you're doing 100. It'll do 110 pretty easily, but the thing is that you can run 100, 80, 90 really easily and no problems. And so we decided we were going to stop and eat here. And we're about half a tank of gas are out. We have a real nice waitress and stuff in here. And it's getting hot. I pulled all my leathers off and changed my coat down and did some stuff. And hey, that was a good place to eat. We filled up there and we're about ready to get some food in us. We're going to try to make one more gas stop and then the rest of the way to San Francisco area. So I don't know, I figured I could go about 50 miles before I hit reserve here, and I got a gallon, and that's another 40 or 50. Probably about 40 at the speed we were going. And it's a beautiful sky. All the rain and everything is blown out. This is one of the original truck stops. My buddy was used to be a truck driver. And before Denny's and this other stuff was here, it was just a big parking lot. I don't remember who owned it. There wasn't any gas pumps or anything, but it was just a place where guys would spend the night. Yeah, my video's lagging behind, I'm pretty sure now. think I'm going to try to pause the audio and start it over again. Well, here we are. We're coming through a stretch of freeway here, and we're coming into, we're getting pretty close to Vallejo, where we want to go. And we're going to be coming up on a toll booth here. And I don't have fast track. I guess I should do that, because I'm, especially with motorcycle, because you got to stop and dig your money out. And I knew I was going to hit this toll booth. And so I put $5 in my shirt pocket, and I already had my glove off. But when you get up there and you're trying to reach with your right hand across your left, which is your clutch hand, and it's a little tricky. It'd be much better to just have a fast track and have it go ahead and read your thing and take the money out and not have to stop at all. Plus, I wouldn't have to be in the cash lane either. And we're going to get up here to it pretty soon. But the day's about over. That toll booth is one of the things I always try to miss. And he somehow he got in front of me here, and so I just split a little traffic to catch up with him. And some idiot up here eventually with a new yellow Camaro. I just had to race around and cut in between you. You know, cars are, they just cut in between motorcycles. They think you're a whole car. They don't realize that two motorcycles is sort of like one car. You're both driving together. And don't realize how hard it is to, once you get split apart, and then he gives you a car length of room, and another car gets in front of him, and pretty soon you got two or three cars between you and the guy ahead of you. And then you see a truck or something like that, he changes lanes, and you don't see him because of the truck, and you just go straight, and he turns off, and now you really get screwed up. So you try to stay pretty close together, and at this speed, the wake that the front motorcycle puts out, if you're directly behind him about 30 or 40 feet, it's not bad. But you're way too close to him. And so back about this distance here, you don't get any wake at all from the motorcyclist's clean air. And if you get over in the other lane, then it's good clean air. It's not interpolated. So as you can see, it's real easy for the car to get in here. And I'm kind of slowing down because of the traffic, and he's not really slowing down and sort of leaving it open. I don't care. I'm tired at this point. I'm close to home. I'm tired of trying to fight with keeping up with somebody, and, you know, I'm just tired, period, driving, and been here a long ways. I think this was this a toll booth here, or did I just go by it? I don't remember. Yeah, you can see here on the right the ocean. This is actually a really nice bridge up here. The way the camera's mounted, you can't tell very well, but this is the Carquinez Bridge. It's called the Carquinez Straits. And it's very pretty, especially from the other side, but with the way the camera's mounted, you can't tell what's going on with it. And this is like the toll booth coming up here. Yeah, it is. See, he's going over on the fast track side, and I thought he's just going to keep going. Well, we both know where we're going. But he slows down up here, and once he gets out of the toll booth, I catch him a few miles later. Because we both live pretty close to the same place. It was a nice day. It wasn't real hot there. And always on Sunday, the traffic coming back is kind of bad because people have been gone for the weekend. But we only had, you know, like 30, 40 miles of traffic. It wasn't too bad at all. And most of it, as you saw, was just out there on the freeway. Yeah, this is the video's kind of jumping. I hope that the audio will be synced up properly to it. I imagine it will be. Then I got to figure out a way to mix the two, where I have more audio and less just that motor running. You really can't hear anything over the top of this motor. Transition right where I don't need it. So I reach in my shirt pocket here and I got a $5 bill. So probably the camera won't pick up much, but maybe I'll hand the money into the booth across the bike. And of course, everybody's behind you wanting you to hurry up. It's easy in a car, you just stick your hand out and give her the money and go on. But I gotta stop and get it neutral and everything else. Here you go, lady. Thank you. You're welcome. Drive safe. Okay. This really looks like I'm here a long time. It's probably just not showing the video. I really wasn't. It was only just a couple seconds, but and I figured I wasn't sure if my buddy had went on home or whether he was hanging around, but you can guess it pretty good through here, and I'm only about 10 miles from home, if that. And it's all very familiar to me, so as far as I'm concerned, the day's over, and kind of done with the real fast freeways. This part here is very interesting. I made some earlier videos of the ocean. It's over to our left. Can't really see it, but it's over there. And up front of us is Mare Island, where they used to build all of the submarines and all the ships. I've had a couple of videos where I went out there to the island, and they still got it's not a destroyer. I don't know. Pretty big boat, some kind of great big Coast Guard boat now. I don't know what it is. And there's a submarine museum out there. It's just an actual submarine like the one they built. And there's a little old man sits there all day and gives tours. Anyway, the rest of this is not very interesting other than just coming here across the bridge. We got just a few more miles of freeway and we'll be home. And that's all. And for the video, it's probably not very interesting. But if you've not ever been to this area, it might be interesting to you. So that's all for now. So long. I'll see you later.